Hey guys, welcome back to today's video. Today is Thursday, November 5th, 2020. Today we're going to be talking about Joe Biden's increasing chances at winning the presidency. As you all know, or maybe you don't know, you're hearing it here first, maybe, in the state of Nevada, they said that at 12 p.m. Eastern Time and 9 a.m. Pacific Time, they will be releasing more results. Well, what we've seen from the state of Nevada so far is that Joe Biden has expanded his lead in this state. It has gone from being less than a percent to roughly a percentage point. Now, the reason why I think that Democrats are pretty hopeful is because a lot of the vote has been counted. The Election Day vote has already been counted, which should have favored Trump, but hasn't. And granted, you know, Nevada sent a ballot to every single voter, so it's very possible that Republicans and Democrats alike both voted by mail. And looking at the outstanding counties, you see a lot of these Republican counties without votes, 80% in, 75% in, which is why the media has not called it for Joe Biden, despite him having a lead. However, there's also the contrary point. In this state, there are two regions where Biden could very well gain more voters. Washoe County, which has Biden ahead by roughly 4 points, if the mail-in vote favors the Democrats the same way it has in the other states or runs even, Biden maintains his lead. Running even or doing better, as he has done, Biden being he, has done in other states, Nevada could turn blue from just this one county. Or we can take a look down in Clark County, one of the most condensed population-wise, which has been releasing more results, just released new results, which has expanded Biden's lead. You can see it there, an 8-point lead for Biden in this county. Any type of increase or even running even would not change the results of the state. So looking at Biden's current lead in Nevada, he should be very happy with where he stands. Democrats should not be too overtly optimistic. This election is still close. But the numbers don't exactly say Trump is going to carry Nevada. Nor do they say that Nevada is locked down for Biden, just that he is the narrow favorite. Now, Democrats see Nevada, and when you add that to this number, 264, you think 270. You think 270 because that's the number needed, but you forget that there exist faithless electors. We've discussed the possibility of the Supreme Court. Their ruling was that electors had to follow state rules, not that they could not vote against their state's winner. So state rules, while some states don't allow electors to be faithless, others do. And it's possible if we're at 270 to 268 that one elector votes for somebody else and it denies Joe Biden the presidency because of, you know, a personal reason, whatever it might be, you know, wanting to be in a history textbook. We don't know. But looking at Biden at 264, I think the Democrats are looking for more of a victory than just 270, right? So where do they get that? Well, they've already won Wisconsin, they've already won Michigan, they've already won Arizona. We've had those calls since last night, practically since Election Day, despite Trump leading in these states. Once all the votes were counted, we're at 99% in, 99% in, Biden has won these states. But the states that you see highlighted in red over here, right in this region of the country, Pennsylvania, North Carolina, and Georgia. Now, two of these states have similar demographics. Pennsylvania is the one that defers. So we'll talk about these briefly. North Carolina, we won't be getting a call till next Friday at the earliest. The reason for that is because if your ballot was postmarked by Election Day, meaning November 3rd, and it arrives anytime between now or November 3rd and the 12th of November, it must be counted, assuming everything else is correct. It must be counted. So we probably won't be seeing, you know, full results in North Carolina because there could be ballots that are in the U.S. Postal Service or on the way postmarked on November 3rd that will be dropped off at North Carolina polling stations. It could be backed up. That's an entire issue. Again, each state has their own requirements, has their own laws, and North Carolina allows votes to be counted till the 12th. So don't count out Joe Biden yet. Right now, Donald Trump maintains a lead of less than 100,000 votes, roughly an 80,000 vote lead over Donald Trump. But the thing is, in North Carolina, there is an outstanding 300,000 ballots. It's from roughly equal areas. However, these ballots are expected to favor Joe Biden, which is why we don't see a call here yet. If they're expected to favor Trump, you can guarantee it. Fox News and a number of other networks would have already called the state of North Carolina, but the fact that they haven't is speaking numbers. Now, in Pennsylvania, Democrats should be a little bit more happy. Joe Biden's loss to Donald Trump on election night in this state was 16 percentage points, 16 percentage points in Pennsylvania. I don't know if you guys remember. I don't know how late you stayed up. I stayed up till roughly 3 a.m. and Pennsylvania did not narrow. It was a 16-point lead for Trump by the time I went to sleep. When I woke up at 6 a.m., it had narrowed up to being actually not around 6 a.m. I think once I actually settled into the day, got ready for the day, a few hours later, it started to narrow down to roughly a 10-point lead. By the end of yesterday, it was down to 5. And today, it is less than 2%. And all we have outstanding, really, in the majority of these counties, sure, a number of, you know, outstanding vote, but a lot of it is already in. And these counties are much, much smaller than Philadelphia, much, much smaller than, Delaware County. And these counties have already reported up here, 93%. Actually, that one, 93 and 93 in Montgomery, actually should be pretty worrisome for the Trump campaign. But looking around here, this is where a lot of Biden's votes are going to be coming in. And this state has narrowed up 13 points since election night. So I think Pennsylvania, the Democrats would really like it. Trump needs it desperately. He's already proclaimed victory in the state of Pennsylvania, but the numbers just don't seem to be favoring Trump today. Now, like I've said in my past few videos, draw your own conclusions. Do not let me sit here and tell you this election is a done deal, because that, first of all, that's not what I'm telling you. But what I'm saying is the Biden camp and Democrats out there should be much happier with these results than even yesterday. Because I have one more state to look at. Let's see if Nevada's updated by the time I've made. No, it hasn't. The state of Georgia. Look at that margin. Wow. 0.3% separates Joe Biden and Donald Trump. 0.3%. Now, some Republicans expect the outstanding counties, which have favored Trump in the vote counted so far, to favor him even more. However, you still have to, you know, account for Atlanta suburban vote. Fulton County, I believe, is 100% reported. They don't actually have all of the county data like I'd like to see, but, you know, they don't have any of the outstanding vote discussed. But there should be, you know, a number of votes out. It's possible that if Biden wins this state, it could be by possibly a few hundred votes, a few thousand votes out of roughly 5 million casts. So it'll probably be one of the closest states that we see this election season. And it has narrowed down from what was a 6-point lead on election night for Trump in Georgia. It could have been higher than that. That was the last number I remember personally. And since narrowed down to 0.3%. And it doesn't exactly get that much better for Republicans in the Senate. They have already won the state of Maine. They have won the state of Maine. They have won the state of Montana. They have won the state of Iowa. They have won the state of Kansas, Texas, South Carolina, Kentucky, states that Democrats targeted. Now, Democrats did win the state of Virginia, Michigan, New Hampshire. Look at that New Hampshire margin up there. Wow, that's safe. I mean, I characterize it as safe, but that's really good. Michigan was exceptionally close, but the Democrats win. In Colorado, a flip. Arizona, a flip. So across this country, the Democrats did okay, nowhere near what they wanted to get, but I think they are much happier with the result that is now out of the state of Georgia because they have a runoff system here. If you don't know how it works, if no candidate reaches 50%, it goes off into a runoff. And look at David Perdue's percent, 49.99%. Now, the Trump camp thinks there's enough votes out there to expand Trump's lead or save it, but at the end of the day, if John Ossoff has so much increases marginally, literally by 0.01%, David Perdue is headed to a runoff in January 2020. And given that the Democratic Party has lost the Senate, if I'm to call it right now, it's possible if the Republicans lose North Carolina that the Democrats win it. But realistically, I mean, both of these Georgia Senate races will likely determine the final party composition, because if North Carolina goes red and Alaska is widely expected to go red, the Republicans hit 50. That leaves both of these Georgia races, assuming they both go into a runoff, the center of national attention till January 5th. So I just wanted to point that out. But looking at the presidential race, Joe Biden has made up numbers in, I should not use that word. Someone is going to try to use that in a very weird conspiracy. Joe Biden has expanded his lead in Nevada. Joe Biden has, you know, narrowed up Donald Trump's lead in Georgia from 6 down to 0.3. In Pennsylvania, from 16 down to less than 2. North Carolina, like I said, we won't be getting results really soon. In Alaska, we won't be getting results for whatever reason. They're around 50% in. They should have called that for Trump, but again, some areas are being a little apprehensive about their calls, but the numbers speak for themselves. Biden is at 264. Trump is at 214. All Biden needs is one more state. He's leading in Nevada. He's doing very well in Pennsylvania compared to where he was before. I mean, look at that margin. It has since narrowed up since the beginning of this video. That's 1.7%. We are looking at, or 1.8%. We are looking at Biden do very well. His popular vote total is surpassing Obama 2008. Donald Trump's very well, might as well. Turnout is high nationwide. And while the Democratic Party, while initially suffering very early defeats in Florida, Ohio, Iowa, Texas, they turned the night around by waiting the long game. And if we're looking at the predicted market, let's go ahead and refresh it here just to get a new sense of the numbers. The money typically won't lie to you. The Democrats, based off the predicted map, have 306 electoral votes. A lot of people already know that Pennsylvania will probably switch back to Biden. I'm not going to tell you that. It's possible. I'm not going to count out Trump yet. It seems that the people with the money have, though. But Pennsylvania, keep an eye out on it. In the state of Georgia, keep a very close eye out for this battleground state. Take a look at Arizona. Look at it. It's been called by Politico. It's been called by Fox News. Nate Silver says retract those calls. They haven't retracted the calls. They probably won't retract the calls. Maricopa County was supposed to help Donald Trump. It isn't helping him as much as he needs it to be. I think Arizona's gone for Trump. But again, that's my two cents. Draw your own conclusions. And Nevada seems to be expected to be more Democrat than Arizona. At least people are much more secure about Nevada than they are Arizona, which happens to be a state already called by the Associated Press, by Politico, by Fox News. So final state, like I said, you know, looking at Georgia, I really think all eyes point to Georgia. All eyes point to Georgia because this state is 16 electoral votes. It could very well avoid, if Trump is to win Pennsylvania, very well avoid the issue of a faithless elector. But right now, I would say that the Biden campaign should be very happy with where they are in Georgia, with this state significantly narrowing up. Look at that, narrowed up since I began this video to 0.2%. It's getting closer. Let's go ahead and check the Senate really briefly. This is crazy. I mean, we are seeing numbers literally change right in front of us. It's down to 49.98%, so it gets a little bit more difficult for David Perdue to avoid a runoff, and I don't think Nevada has changed, and I don't believe Pennsylvania has changed either, obviously not North Carolina. So that's pretty much it. Biden's campaign should be happier than before. Again, no complacency. The votes have already been cast, so there's no reason to think that being complacent about where you are right now should change the outcome of the election, but I just want to point out that this still is anyone's ballgame. So thank you guys so much for watching this video. Make sure to comment down suggestions below. Subscribe on the left if you haven't already and check out the Instagram and Twitter. At the bottom left of the screen, there's also a Discord server for you to go ahead and join. On the screen, there's a video you can watch and then a playlist for my 2024 election prediction. I've only had one so far, but again, we're probably going to be going through that sometime soon. Thank you guys so much for watching. I will see you all later today.